We want to find the product using base 10 blocks. We have 4 times 3 tenths. Because we're working with decimals, we'll define the base 10 blocks as follows. The 10 by 10 block, or the flat, is one whole. The 1 by 10 block, or the long, equals 1 tenth. And the 1 by 1 block, or the bit, is equal to 1 hundredth. So because we have 4 times 3 tenths, this means we want 4 sets or 4 copies of 3 tenths. Notice to model 3 tenths, we would use 3 longs, because each long equals 1 tenth. So to find our product, we want 4 copies or 4 sets of 3 longs. And again, because each long is 1 tenth, here's 1 copy of 3 tenths, a second copy of 3 tenths, a third copy of 3 tenths, and a fourth copy of 3 tenths. Notice how we have a total of 12 longs, or 12 tenths, and because we have 10 or more longs, we can perform an exchange. Since 10 tenths equals 1, we can exchange 10 longs for 1 flat, which represents 1 whole. So now we have a total of 1 flat and 2 longs, which should be 1 plus 2 tenths, or 1 and 2 tenths. And therefore, 4 times 3 tenths is 1 and 2 tenths. If they were asked to express this in expanded form, which actually more closely fits the answer we found using our base 10 blocks, 1.2 is equal to, again in expanded form, going back to our base 10 blocks, would be 1 plus 2 tenths, or 1 plus 0.2. So using base 10 blocks to model the product of a whole number and a decimal can be a nice way to visualize the product. I hope you found this helpful.